Colin, where are you? Can you hear me?
Vlad, I'm following that guy. Something's not right about him.
To me, Colin!
Jacob Rivers, marked for termination.
Are you all right, Jacob? Jacob! Hours later, they found me lying in front of her hideout. I made it out alive, but not all of us did. Colin's dead, and the stranger I saw is nowhere to be found. I told them about everything. I said that it wasn't safe for them to be with me. But Jennifer suggested that right now, nowhere is safe, so we might as well stick together. Everyone pulled through as we prepared for the worst, but nothing happened.
Jacob? Are you awake?
How long have you been sitting there?
Not that long. I know that you're going to that hospital today, so I went on my first scavenging run. And I found something for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you go with your sister?
No. As soon as Erin heard that there's a hospital nearby, she asked Jennifer to go look for some medicine. So I went alone. Don't tell her that, okay?
She's already at the medical district?
Yep. And Ryan wanted to talk to you.
His rifle cauterized the wound. That's why he's not bleeding. But damage to the skin made the burn prone to infection. That's what we need to worry about.
Wow. You're really smart.
I learned all that before the war, and thanks to Judgment Day, I didn't even have to pay off my my student loan. Morning. Patrick came to me earlier, asking if I thought you'd like his present. When I saw that it was a single bullet, I wasn't sure if he was being helpful or if it was a warning. I figured he didn't appreciate you looking at his sister like that.
Do you need help with anything?
No, I'm fine. I had to learn to do things by myself for quite a while, sweetie. Now, tell me, what did you really want to ask me?
How did you know about the Annihilation Mine?
I heard the rumors, like everyone else. And then, like everyone else, I decided to ignore them. I was in the middle of operating on a little girl. When I had finished, I realized that we were surrounded. The machines killed most of us, but they decided to keep me alive. So, that's how I ended up in a camp. Maybe they thought it would be worth having a doctor in there. I don't know.
What happens at those camps?
People get tortured, experimented on, cut to pieces. I couldn't watch at first, but I soon realized that I had to do what no one else could. I had to bear witness to the atrocities. You're actually the first person that wasn't afraid to ask. They're all scared of me, like I'm carrying some sort of disease. But they're still coming to me for medicine. Ironic, isn't it?
Do you think you could help more people by joining the Resistance?
Honey, maybe ask me that question when you finally find them. Because for now, I don't think they even exist.
Hey, you're off again? I'll see you later. I'm gonna stay here and help Aaron.
Okay, now sit. Roll over. Fetch. We've got a lot to learn. Jacob, thank you for finding him for me. I promise I'll take good care of him. Now, what should I call him?
How about Max?
That's a good name. I like that.
You wanted to talk to me?
First of all, thank you for bringing me that toolkit. That bus should be ready in no time. Good to see you finally turn the corner. I wanted to talk to you. I'm starting to get worried about Jennifer. It's been a while since she left, and at my age, I try to worry as little as possible. If you see her out there, send her back, okay?
Sneak up on me like that. It's bad enough with those creepy noises.
What noises?
Every once in a while, there's this unbearable scream coming from that hospital. We need to see what's going on. Let's move. Let me. Picking locks is kind of my thing. Silverfish got him. They're every scavenger's nightmare. Look, this poor guy is still holding a sound decoy.
Sound decoy?
You resistance guys just shoot at everything that moves, don't you? Silverfish are sensitive to noise, so before it pops up from the ground and starts chasing, you throw a sound decoy. It'll draw any nearby silverfish away. I guess you can take it. You won't be needing it anyway. Hear that? That's the sound I was talking about.
I don't think you should go any further.
And what about you?
I have to go. That could be the resistance.
I understand. Stupid asking you this, but Aaron wanted me to find some antibiotics for Mark. I know I'm not making it easy on you, but if you're in there and you find some, we would really appreciate it.
I'll see what I can do.
Remember that your gun won't do you any good against Terminators. So when you see one, do what I do. Sneak past them. I'll be waiting for you at the hideout. Take care.
Right now, you need to start answering some questions.
There will be a time for that, but right now, you need to help the people inside. As for Colin, there was nothing I could have done. It was either him or... you. And it couldn't have been you.
Hello? This is it. Thank you. I wonder if I could control those turrets with a hacking device. From the Resistance. The others have to be here too. Private Jacob Rivers, Pacific Division.
Pacific? What the hell happened up there? The whole division went silent.
It was wiped out. I'm the only one who survived, and I need to meet with Commander Baron.
All right, I'll make sure you get to do that. But first, get us out of here. Follow that staircase. It'll lead you to the main generator. Overload it, and turn off the laser grid.
Understood.
And Rivers, destroying that generator will make a lot of noise. So in case we get separated, where are you stationed?
Just south from here.
Okay, we'll find you. Baron will want to meet you. Now go, and watch out for those metals.
Thank you.
I'm on my way out.
Good job. I can see the soldiers leaving. But don't think it's done. Skynet's sending green voices.
Thank you.
Thank you.